Okay, we're back, and in Cherry Tree High Comedy Club, where we don't have that much time left to recruit people. We have, like, exactly 2 weeks to recruit 3 people. And I got some very helpful comments about what everyone likes, except for Tyler, because no one seems to like him. So, that is awesome. So, there were some surprises. I had no idea Curtis liked politics, for example, and stuff. And we are, for some reason, fairly good at politics. I say fairly. Yeah, we can talk about that. We could go work on our history, too, because Vivian likes that, and sports and stuff. But we'll go get Curtis on our side first. I guess we should, you know, go to bed. Wait, how much money do we have? $790. Wow, that's awesome. But I would kind of like to... Wait. Oh no, we have school tomorrow. Oh, it doesn't matter. Maybe it does. Maybe we should read something tomorrow in school, though. Let's go call Curtis because we can. And now I've got the sun in my eyes. Cool. Because we're building a bit on the relationship then. Go away, son. Alright, 17th. Don't have that much time left. It's lunch break, but I feel lousy. What? You're less fatigued than before. What are you talking about, Miley? Hello, hello. Okay, I kind of don't have to talk to people anymore because we already know what they like. Well, not Tyler, actually. Okay, Tyler. Proportions and bearing all play a big role in making a dress look good. I guess he likes fashion. Maybe? He knows about fashion. Let's pretend he likes fashion. La 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 la. I like how the consensus of everyone is like, not Tyler. He is creepy. Which makes me intrigued about Tyler's story. I might, since I have multiple saves right now, I might possibly, I don't know if it will work, but maybe I can try to, you know, get everyone's storyline, basically. Yeah, read a mag. Well, okay, well, I mean, that's good. We want to talk to Curtis about politics, so. Yeah, after school. Alright, so I'm gonna go look for my bottles. Okay, so we'll go talk to Curtis. Curtis, please be recruited. Yeah, I'm following you. Duh. Politics. Spend time talking to Curtis about politics. Curtis is a huge politics fan. I had absolutely no idea. We had a fun and lively chat. We're gonna recruit him. Yay! Miley, I'd like to talk to you about something. What? Don't keep me in suspense. Ah, but don't pledge eternal love or anything. Inter-duo romances can go horribly wrong. Don't worry, that isn't. Actually, I went to a comedy club. Say what? Did you see your dad? Yeah. Why did you do that? Why? Miley, you're the one who encouraged me. Well, yeah, but... I tried doing what you're good at, looking at things in a different light. And I did get something out of it. I mean... I was sort of impressed. He was funny, right? Alright, he was funny. I was surprised by how much I laughed. And everyone else in the audience had a great time too. I left thinking stand-up comedy isn't half bad. Yeah, right? That's the power of a first-rate pro. Huh. I never really gave it a chance before. I had my personal problems with my dad, and they colored my perceptions. Glad the misconceptions cleared up. It's thanks to you, Miley. Much as I hate to admit it. You didn't have to say the last bit. But as for the first part, I'm flattered. I wasn't a pain in the neck, wasn't I? I did keep pestering you. Oh no, I was kinda happy. Before you, I didn't have anyone to talk comedy about comedy with. As for me, your constructive criticism helped a bunch, Curtis, so we're even. Huh. So, here. Curtis gave you his club application! What's this? I can't read it. There's sand in my eye. Read it for me, would you? It's the sign-up sheet for your club. I thought I could still learn a little more from you. But I'm joining on a provisional basis. Gotcha. Alright, welcome to the club, bub. Hooray, you're the first! Now I need two more people. Huh? I'm the first member? Maybe I spoke too soon. Anyway, I'll be counting on you. Right back at ya. Well, then I'll see you later. Oh, he did a nice disappearing act there. Huh? Hi, Mr. Campbell! Perfect timing. I just want to give you my thanks. Did I do something good? Recently, my son's been opening up more. We're actually having conversations. Even about comedy, if you can't believe it. I never thought I'd see the day that I talked to my son about my work. And it's thanks to you, Miley. I hope you'll stay friends with him. He needs looking after. What can I say? Now I'm all embarrassed. Yay! You successfully persuaded Curtis to join the club. Now we just need two more people in 2 weeks. Yay! Hey, Curtis. Alright. So, who else do we go with? I kind of want Vivian. And then I don't know. What I've heard from you guys is mostly Sarah or May. I actually didn't want to look at that, but sure. A new friend, a new CTHCC member! Yeah. Or maybe Sarah and May, because I've already got them at level 2, but on the other hand, I don't think getting Vivian to level 2 will be very hard, I hope. I don't know. Let's go for May. Actually, I've never seen May's story either. I only actually know Curtis and Cindy's stories. That's the only people I managed to recruit last time, and I got Vivian to like level 4. So, I don't know. But, okay, so if we go for May, let's say May, maybe? She likes to talk about, let's see, we have left for her travel, pets, cooking, perhaps history and sports. I don't know which of these is what she likes the most, but yay! We'll pretend that she likes everything, so. What did I say? Travel? I think we're pretty good at travel. Yeah. Travel, pets. We're pretty good at pets, too. Cooking. Yeah, cooking. I've been working the cooking there. History. Not very good. And sports is not very good. And history and sports is basically what we need for Vivian and art. So, you know. We should save. It's going awesome! We have one! We just need, you know, two more. Maybe I should actually do another save. Let's do that. So either we call someone, or we like watch TV and hope it's something nice on. Let's watch TV and pretend there's something awesome on. Oh my god, cooking, really? Now we have cooking level 5? I dearly hope May likes to talk about cooking. But that was kind of unexpected, actually. Sure. Alright, I'm gonna go talk to hang out with May for a bit right now. Actually, maybe we should go to the library and read. Because... History. We can read about history in the library. Some people like to talk about history. Yeah, let's do it. Yes, history. Oh, come on, come on. Yes, history skill. All right, let's go find May and talk to her about cooking. Or food, you know. But first,
the bottles.
Alrighty, I don't even know how many bottles I have. 14! We can totally get... Oh, wait a minute. We have a club up? Oh, I didn't even know you got club application like an item. Yeah. Alright, May. Talk to me about... Let's save cooking. Let's do, like, travel. Which one is travel? Oh yeah, this one is travel. Okay, cool. Talking with May about travel. Seems May likes travel. Yeah, nice chat together. Nothing else happened. Thanks. Okay, we've talked to her about travel. So yeah, I mean, it is worth it calling people, for example, in the evenings and stuff like that, because then you build, you know, a little on the relationship, so. Yay, we now have $10. Okay, I don't know if we necessarily need to call May this time, because if we talk to her again, should be good, but, let's watch TV, just because. Music! Not what I was going for, but all our skills are increasing. Alright, Saturday. Okay, we do not have a lot of days left. Drats. Alright, May. Come on. Please. History. Or sports, because I'm so bad at sports. Come on, please. Okay, let's do it. Yes, okay. I like, you know, sacrificed the sport. All right. Here we go. Hey, Miley. I know, I give her baby voice. Hey, Miley, I have a favor to ask. Sure, what is it? There's somewhere I'd like to go. It's down by the station, so, let's go first, and I'll explain later. Okay... It wouldn't happen to be that store Sweet Sweets, would it? Yeah, there's one in front of the station, right?
I think so.
Yes, there's one in the mall there. That's cute. Not wanting to go somewhere unfamiliar by yourself. Ugh. Alright, what are we waiting for? Let's go! And so, Miley and May made their way to the mall and checked out the Sweet Sweets. I want to read it's like Sweet and Sweets or something, but... Sweet Sweets. That caramel was so sweet, and the gummy bears were nice and soft. Hey, what's wrong?
Well... They had so many customers there.
Well, that's because only neighborhood kids visit your store. And I guess chain stores have that standardization thing going for them. They all sell the same stuff, so you always know what you're getting.
The store's so big, too. It didn't feel like a candy store at all. I was shocked.
I guess it makes it easier for people to wander in. But personally, I think the candy stores should feel small and homey. I prefer the smaller stores.
You do? I wonder.
Hey, don't let it get to you.
I'm trying not to.
Look at it this way. Just like in comedy, you've gotta know your customers and what they want. Sure, Sweet Sweets gets a lot of people, but you have customers too, don't you? People all have different tastes, and they frequent the stores they feel are best suited to them. As long as you have happy customers, you're fine. Well, profitability aside.
You should be proud that you have kids who come to your store every day. That's gotta count for something. Thanks, Miley. And thanks for coming out with me today. You definitely cheered me up. Good. And if you ever want to talk again, just let me know. Can you get home on your own? Bah, of course, silly. Okay, see ya.
Oh, hello. You're May Bonbon's friend, correct? Oh yeah, I forgot. I gave her the robot voice.
Haha, yep.
Or the elevator voice.
Hey, you came by the store the other day. I won't let you capital pigs take over any more of our town, you hear? Now beat it.
As I thought, you misunderstood us. It is our group policy not to proceed with a development if local people oppose it.
Oops, well, I was only joking just now.
May knows that joining your chain isn't a bad offer, but as you know, the store is also her home, so it's hard for her to accept.
Yes, I understand. So please give her a little more time. She needs to form her own decision on this. Until now, she's always counted on me or her grandpa. This is a good chance for her to stand on her own 2 feet.
I see. In that case, please ask her to take her time. Now, if you'll excuse me, I shall casually walk right by you.
Miley laughed and headed home for home.
Afternoon.
Oh, I guess technically we can go talk to May again if we want. When I found all my bottles.
Now the question is, May, like, what we have left for May to talk about is pets, cooking, and history. And we are pretty good at cooking. Like, we're level 5, which is apparently the maximum level.
So that means we should be able to have a really good talk with May about cooking if she likes that. Hopefully that will give us an entire new level. But if it doesn't, then I guess we kind of have to talk to her about something completely random. Which is not romance or politics, you know? Like, sacrifice something.
Or maybe we want to, you know, keep cooking for a later level?
Eh. She likes pets and she likes history. We should probably work more on our history.
You know what? Let's do it.
Screw it.
Hey, talk to me about cooking.
No. Stop.
We already talked to her about cooking! What? Why haven't I...
Oh, gosh. I had it.
Okay. Well, that changes the whole situation. Yeah, we're not talking to you. Sorry. No, I wanted the bookstore. On the other hand, I don't have... Okay, I hadn't made the correct mark on my paper. I thought we hadn't talked to her about cooking. We have pets and history left for May.
Yeah, we probably want to work some more on our repertoire there.
Our sports history and arts for Vivian?
Well, we're not that good at it, I've gotta say. Maybe we should... Could go make money, of course. Gonna be fatigued, but... Or we'll go and hope that we'll learn more history. Please?
Yes!
Come on. Well, obviously, our history's not gonna go up, but... Just by that, but... Okay, let's call May. Here in the evening. Okay, let's save. Actually. Hello. Recruiting is awesome. Actually, I'll save all this. Okay, let's call May. Hey, May! Talk to me! You and May talked until late at night! That should up our chances. Next time we talk to her. I guess we should ditch Vivian and go with trying to get Sarah. Because we're better at the things that Sarah likes to talk about. Just to actually get through the game. You know. Okay, we'll do like this. I know that time is up for this episode, but what I'll do is we'll talk to May. And if we don't get like a better level with her now, then we're gonna cut the episode and then, you know, we'll start next time at this same spot, but do something else. So, what was left for her? History and pets. So let's go with pets. Hello! Talk to me about pets, sweetie. May likes pets. Yes! Okay, good. One more level. Sis, can I talk to you? Of course, what's up? It's about the shop. Oh yeah, did you come to a decision?
Yes, I'm going to shut it down.
Oh, really? Hang on a minute, seriously?
Yeah, I figured I shouldn't just cling to it.
Then, are you leaving town?
Yes, we'll have to. So I'm sorry, sis, but I can't join your club.
Oh, that. Don't worry about that. Are you sure about this? Did you decide after thinking it through?
Of course.
I see. Well, if that's your choice, after serious thought, who am I to argue?
I don't believe it. I mean, seriously?
I was so certain there was no way she'd ever quit. So I called all my regular customers, and they're coming over here today.
Hey there.
Miss Dina!
Drop the miss, especially in public. It makes me sound old.
Sorry. It's come to this because I couldn't save the shop.
Don't be a dummy. Do you really think this is your fault? Well, yes. This place has been around since I was a kid. I'm sad to see it go. Times change. You can't do anything about that, so don't worry about it.
Yeah.
Hey, you're leaving town? I hope you'll come back once in a while. And when you do, come stay at my dorm. We'll put you up for a night. Didn't you say you want to stay over?
Yes, thank you.
Oh.
I have come to bid you farewell.
Sheesh, in that getup? You sound like a sore thumb.
These are my best clothes. Elise.
So I shall no longer be able to purchase sweet treats from here after school. Such a pity.
I'm sorry.
Oh no, it isn't as though I never expected this to happen, at some point. I will cherish the memories of this shop, both the looks and tastes. I shall never forget it. Consider it my tribute to the shop.
I will, thank you.
That's the important thing, keeping what's most precious to you in your heart. I hope you will never forget this town and this shop. That's a wish from a friend who grew up here, just like you.
Yes, I'll always remember.
Oh, dear Lord, hello, Mr. Campbell. Long time no see.
Oh, Mr. Campbell, thank you so much for coming.
What the? Even Mr. Campbell's here?
Sure, I was a regular when I was a tyke. Or something. It's embarrassing to admit, but I was a little devil when I was young. I cost the owner, Mr. Bonbon, all kinds of grief. Boy, those were the days.
Heh, I wasn't expecting that.
Gramps is inside, so if you'd like to see him.
I certainly would.
I'm sorry to have called you here.
Not at all.
These are the documents you left with me. I read them all thoroughly and signed them. Here you are.
Thank you.
I
wish you wouldn't look at me like that. Are you certain this is what you want?
I'm sorry. I don't have regrets about... please take good care of the shop after we leave.
I promise not to do anything that would disappoint you. I hope that gives you comfort.
Seriously? I did not expect this to happen either in May's storyline.
Well, that about does it.
May, you're really sure about this?
yes. I gave it a lot of thought before deciding, so it's fine.
Okay, as long as it's what you want.
I'm going to miss your smell, too.
What do you mean, my smell?
You smell like the candy shop.
Well, what? I do not.
Well, about time for me to go home, too. Tell me when you're gonna move and I'll help out.
I will. Bye-bye.
May, wherever you go, we'll always be friends.
But.
My smell. She's right. I smell like the shop. My hands. Since when did they start smelling like Grandma's hands?
Miley left May and returned home.
What? What is this? What?
Mind blown. I did not expect that at all.
What?
But that can't happen. Wait, level 4 does make sense. Huh. I'm actually pretty near getting her. Oh, this might work. This might work. If we try to recruit Sarah instead of Vivian, I think we're totally gonna make it. And then, yeah, I might try to replay and get through Vivian, Tyler, and Cindy so we can check out all their storylines. But for now, this is where we're gonna take a break because we're way over time. Actually, we're not. Wait, how long do I usually make these episodes? 20? 30? Yeah, okay, this is perfect time to break. Oh, I'm spinning on my screen. Okay, definitely can take a break. Thank you all so much for watching and playing Cherry High Tree Comedy Club. And I'm so happy that I can share this game with you because I really like it myself. And I'm so happy you do too. So thank you, and I'll see you later.